This is going to be like a very quick example of what I'm trying to say. This is after I recorded the video I just made for this. So basically, you have your premium and discount. It doesn't always have to come down to discount pricing. You know, essentially, you want to see your PD arrays on the higher end of your premium discount hold before you see it come down to the order block. So for instance, if your breaker was above your fair value gap in your order block, you want to see your breaker hold first, okay? If that's not holding, that's your first sign that this is not as bullish as you think it is, okay? So now your next option is your fair value gap. Now you want to see this hold. If it's not showing you willingness to go higher, the trend is not as bullish as you think it is, and it's not respecting the first PD rate. Now it's not respecting the second. Now it leaves you with your order block. This is your last line of defense. You want to see your order block hold. If it's not respecting, then that means clearly this was the draw on liquidity. Now a lot of the times, your fair value gap is above your breaker. It doesn't have to have this specific order, okay? So your breaker could be down here, like this. Your fair value gap could be up here. And price doesn't even have to come down to the 50%. It could literally hit your fair value gap in premium and then continue bullishly. And the reason for that is because it's actually better to see price hold on the higher end of the range than it is the lower end. And that's simply because it's bullish. If the trend is bullish, you want to see stuff on the higher end hold before you see stuff on the lower end hold. It's just that simple. Do not overcomplicate it. And you have your premium discount. All right, this one's gonna be on how to know what order blocks and PD arrays are gonna hold and which ones are not gonna hold. So the best way to put it is, if you were expecting the drawn liquidity, so if you were expecting bullish price action, like let's just say to this high, if you were expecting this high to get purged, then you know what order blocks and PD arrays are going to hold, because this is the draw on liquidity. So if price is going to remain bullish, then down close candles like this are going to hold. So you have three, and then it rallies, leaving liquidity, and then it raids it and then rallies. So this would be your order block. Not these, not that, this one. So you have to have a draw on liquidity, or you have to have something you're aiming for. So when you figure out what you're aiming for a target, like this high, or maybe even these highs, then you want to see how price is respecting your order blocks. So you can see down here, we were bearish. Price comes up. Now it's not respecting this fair value gap. It's not respecting this fair value gap. Comes down, then takes out the high. Leaves this low. So now you have a range from here to here. Premium discount. Price retraces, comes down, rallies up once more. Now you have consecutive down close candles. Now you have consecutive down close candles. So that means all these would be your order block. All these would be your order block. And when price rallies away from it, you want to ask yourself, where's the draw on liquidity? You could say these highs. You could say these highs. These highs, these highs, any of these highs. The only way you're going to know if your bias is correct or not is simply just studying how price respects these PD arrays or these order blocks. So if you see price not respecting them, then that's an early warning that it's probably not going to hold. But the example I wanted to show is this one. So you see price right here swept some liquidity down here. We swept liquidity and then we rallied. But up here, we also swept liquidity right there, these highs. So we swept the low, came up, swept the high, we came in, we came back into the range. So how you kind of want to see it, which is how I see it, is if price is going to remain bullish and we're still going to continue this uptrend, then you want to see your fair value gap. You want to see your PD raise on the higher end hold first. So you want to see your fair value gap hold. If this doesn't hold, this whole fair value gap, like I'd say to the 50%, if it doesn't hold above that, that's like an early, that's like your first warning that price is not as bullish as you expected it to be. So that's one warning. Now if your breaker does not hold, this is another early warning. That's like your second warning that price is gonna probably go down lower. And then your order block. If your order block is not holding, that's like your last line of defense in this scenario. Because every time you have premium and discount, you're not always gonna have a breaker, an order block, a fair value gap. You're not always gonna have these. This just, like, for instance, we do have one. We have a breaker, up close, order block, and fair value gap. So in this case, we do have some, but like a lot of instances, like this one, we didn't have one from this low to this high, nor did it come down to discount. But there's reasons on that, and I'm going to get into that later. But you really want to see like your fair value gap, because it's up high, higher than the breaker, as your first line of defense, your breaker as your second, your order block as your final line of defense. If price is going to remain bullish, you don't even want it coming down here, for one. So that's kind of how I see price action. But I'm going to show you something. This was clearly the drawn liquidity right here, this high. Now, you really want to study price action as it's headed towards that high. I'm going to put some stuff on the chart. To premium discount first. So you see prices rallying, pulling back, rallying, coming back to discount, rally, coming back to discount, rally, coming back to discount. It's respecting the higher end. Like, you see how it's not, if you were to break down the low end, it's not coming down to 50%. It's respecting the higher end. Down here, it's not coming down. It's bullish. It's a good bullish trend. Down here, it's respecting the higher end, because you really don't want to see price coming far down in discount, because that's like an early warning that the trend is not strong. It's staying above 50% of the 50%. So that being said, something you want to study too is the stop rates that occur. Just notice how every single time we rally, right? So from here we rally. We took out lows, equal lows, rallied. We had a low here, we took it out, and we rallied. We have a low here, price goes beneath it, accumulates, and rallies. We have a low here, it dips beneath it and raids, and then rallies, okay? Once again, dips beneath and rallies. And check out the time that these occur as well. So if you look at the very bottom, this occurred at 5 o'clock. That is London kill zone. This one occurred at 5 o'clock. That's lending kill zone. This one occurred at 9 o'clock, New York kill zone. This one occurred at 9 o'clock, New York kill zone. And this one occurred at 5 o'clock, London. The point is it's an algorithm that's ran on time, and you can clearly see that price is respecting the higher end of the PD arrays, and it's operating at a certain time of the day. And if I were to just draw out the order blocks and breakers, you see how we have this down close candle, and then price rallies above it. It comes back down, and it respects the higher end and continues bullish. That's why sometimes you don't have to see it pull back down to the 50%. Because you ideally, you want to see it respect the higher end. You don't want it coming down here, down this low. Once again, it taps the order block, rallies, comes all the way down to the order block, right? Down close candle. Now, why am I using this one and not this down close? Because this one has more body to it, you know? Like, this one has more body. So, it's better than this one. This one, more body. This one, the biggest body. So, price taps the reclaimed order block because it tapped. This is a reclaimed order block because it taps it once, comes back, taps it twice, and then rallies. Back to the order block, rallies. And this is your breaker. You could say this is an order block. Arguably a breaker. I call this a breaker. It's an order block, but ideally it's your breaker because it did sweep this low and this low. So, and then your rallies. And then when you add the stop raids on top, so exit that. Stop raids. Notice what it does before it hits the order blocks. So before it even hits this order block, it swept some sort of liquidity at a specific time in the day and then rallies. Same thing. Before it taps this reclaimed order block, it swept some sort of liquidity and then rallies. And this occurred at 9 o'clock. Swept liquidity inside of an order block. Rallies, breaker, inside of a breaker, rallies, 5 o'clock. The only way you're gonna know, like, if this is gonna occur and head bullishly and continue this bullish trend is by, one, simply having your draw on liquidity and seeing how prices, is the PD arrays holding or are they not? If they're not holding, then you shouldn't expect this to get hit. They clearly are holding, so that's like your first indication that this is a good trend. And for this time frame specifically, you do want to go down and look at your actual sessions, like your power of three. You want to see how price opens, dips beneath the opening price, shift structure, and give you the same thing that you're looking at here. So when I say shift structure, I'm saying premium discount. So the only way you're gonna know is if you know how to blend time and price and draws on liquidity. That's really the only way you're gonna know. You can't just come into this market and with these concepts and just think. One thing I can't stand is when people think, this is an order block. This is an order block. This is an order block. Why didn't these hold? They're not coming in here with an actual context on why they should and shouldn't hold. It's because a lot of people are teaching a lot of other people the concepts that ICT teaches the wrong way. And it's misleading people, bro. So you can't just think every down close candle is going to be a bullish order block, and every up close candle is going to be a bearish order block. Because if that's the case, this should have held. It didn't. And there's a reason why it didn't. And there's a reason why you would, there's a reason why you know that this high and this high would get taken out at this specific level. Because when you see lows like this, three lows, you know, a lot of people see this as support. Well, I don't know if it's support or resistance. I'm not retail, but when you see three bounces like this, they think, oh, it's rejecting. Then price drops beneath it. Then you have breakout traders who are trying to short this, right? And this is for more of my advanced ICT students. I'm just going to like a little lecture. But people see this as support. They think it's going to hold. Price essentially goes beneath it, triggering breakout traders trying to take this thing short. And then they see it bounce, hitting this. I'm not sure if it turns to resistance, so it broke, comes back, and then it rallies down again. So now you got people going in short, but the real narrative is long. And the only way you're going to know is just by looking in this segment of price that where it raids these liquidity. You want to plot your line, your vertical line at the true day open, and just watch this session. Specifically this session, you want to see is it willing to go higher now? And if and it's going to give you an indication it's willing to go higher, but you really want to study price in here and see. And the only reason why you would consider this going bullish is because of these equal highs and correlated pairs. So you really want to have your draws on liquidity. That's the only way you're going to be able to know what order blocks are going to hold and which ones are not going to hold, is just by having a draw on liquidity or a fair value gap. Like, you have to set the bar and aim for it, and then study how price gravitates towards that that bar you set. And that's called tape reading. What ICT is doing in this YouTube mentorship is he's trying to teach people how to read the tape. Like, he's trying to teach people how to set the bar and then study how price goes towards that objective. Is it going there bullishly and respecting, or is it not? That's really what he's emphasizing on. I watched the first few videos of his mentorship. I get it. I know how to study that stuff for myself. I do like going there to learn new concepts and stuff. Well, not new concepts, but I like to learn, how he uses these. But the moral of the story is you have to set the bar first on where your draw is, and then study how price gravitates towards that that draw that you set. And I am going to put my Instagram in the description. And at the end of this, there's going to be a video on a live execution I took today on GU. Yeah. So you really have to have a narrative. You have to have a narrative and a draw. That's the only way you're going to know if these order blocks are going to hold. You can't just come in here looking for patterns and thinking that these patterns, like, if you want to test your probability, then yes, you got to come in here looking for that stuff without any other context. But other than that, you have to aim for something and then walk towards it, you know, with the candlesticks. That's like the best way I can describe it. And I'm going to put my Discord in the description as well. But here's the execution.
I got Tosi on the way. bring back kids. Here I went for real, you not my fleas. Hang up, beat it up in the body, you not my bill. Yeah, drinking X, money with perk, that's my seed. I got money coming in different ways, I'm popping shit. Everything I imagined in my mind, I done accomplished it. I was serving chickens in the mail. How you want the double C, but no Chanel.